There's no avoiding it.
Well, it's head on head.
Rugby is a contact sport. But even those who love it now see it has to change to prevent new generations of players suffering potentially catastrophic head injuries. Few love the game more than Phil Batty, England rugby's team doctor from 2012 to 2014. But he admits not enough's been done to protect players suffering concussion injuries. He himself has been guilty of that.
I am a human being, I've made mistakes. I have sent people back onto the field of play that at the time I did not know were concussed. And I would have wished there was greater sort of tools available for me at that time.
Now a respected sports injuries consultant, Dr. Batty says rugby needs to listen to the injured players and their families, but can be reluctant to do so.
I think there are vested interests in the game. There are some administrators that may not recognise the seriousness of it.
That seriousness underlined by the stories of players like former England under 21 Neil Spence. The ex-Leicester and Gloucester back row says his family have had to watch his deterioration and personality change with dementia brought on by countless head injuries.
I used to be the life and soul of the party, Mr. Happy, Mr. Outgoing, but now I've lost my confidence. I seem to be dazed, confused, unsure of what I'm doing.
Yeah, every time the ball's touched and goes down, then you're going to play.
Ahead of any official changes in the sport, some schools like Egham International in Surrey have already switched to non-contact touch rugby. School athletics director Jamie Johnston, who once played rugby for Harlequins, makes this surprise admission.
I wouldn't encourage my own kids to play. Not with the game as it is at the moment. We need to start thinking about the safety of our kids and addressing that issue.
Both the teacher and the former England doctor believe rugby still has so much to offer, but has to become safer to ensure its future.
I love the game of rugby and I really want it to thrive, but it needs to change.
Leading academics will argue tomorrow that change must start with banning all tackling in schools. The Rugby Football Union today insisted player welfare remains its number one priority. Paul Davis, News at 10.